Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects 3DP. Today we're going to review a very cool set of devices provided by ATEZR. As you may have recognized from the intro, they are the ATEZR P10 10W Laser Engraver, their silent air pump, and their automatic roller for cylindrical objects. So all the devices came inside this big box. Thank you ATEZR for doing that, and not sending three different boxes. Here on top we'll find some paperwork that are different instructions for all the devices, as well as the metallic protective sheet for the table. Directly underneath the foam, we'll find every single component perfectly organized, as you can see. Starting from this plastic bag, there are a couple cables inside that I don't really know what will be for. Here we have more plastic bags, another one, and two more. Then one of those anti-humidity paper bags with little balls inside. Something that we don't used to see in the laser unboxings. Continuing, we have the air assist tube, more cables, and this little brush. Then, removing all the foams, we start discovering some more components. First, a really cool pair of goggles. Definitely are different from the typical included in every machine that used to be all the same. What? Continuing with the unboxing, we'll find two metallic legs right here. Here we have a third one, and this should be the last one. Okay, so next, here we have the laser module itself. As you can see, it is very compact and includes the laser protector at the bottom, as well as the air conduit in the design. Next, we find the air compressor, very well built in anodized aluminum and with the power knob. Here is the rotary roller, as you can see, very well built. We'll test it out later on. This should be my new smartphone. Looking good, right? Just kidding. It is the touchscreen for controlling the machine that will connect via HDMI. This other device right here, I have no idea what we'll use it for, but we'll figure out later on. Next, we'll start finding the profiles of the main structure. This must be one of the sides. Notice that all the moving components are already installed inside. Very cool. Here we have the other side. This looks like the back profile of the structure, and this must be the front, that as you can see, has the boards and all the electronics right here on the side. Oh, looks like we have four more feet, this time shorter. I imagine that the long feet will be used for the rotary roller. Here we have a metallic rod that I'm pretty sure we'll use to synchronize the two sides of the y-axis. And finally, here we have what looks like the x-axis gantry of the device, that as you can see has the motor and moving components already installed in place. It's been a very long unboxing, right? There were definitely a lot of components inside that single box. Now let's have a closer look at the smaller ones we took out at the beginning of the unboxing. Starting with this plastic bag, we find a full HDMI cable. Next, another USB-A to USB-B cable to add to my extensive collection. Then we have more cables that look like stepper motor cables, and I think we'll need to use them to connect the rotary roller to the machine. Next, we have the power brick, which is quite big by the way, and outputs 120 watts, together with its power extension cord right here. Here we have the little brush I showed you before, and then this little cable that looks like a splitter and will probably use to power the rotary roller or the air compressor. This really cool blower air pipe that is so satisfying to touch, and also this bag where we'll find all the bolts to build the machine. Please, manufacturers of the planet, learn from ATEZR how to properly tag the bolts. They are even organized by steps. Amazing. Then we have some more cable clips, a cleaning cloth, some sample materials including basswood and acrylic, some more black acrylic tags, a USB reader with the microSD card, a set of wrenches, and some zip ties. If we have a closer look at the instructions, as you can see, they are in full color and very well explained, so we're going to start from here. For that, we'll need the step 1 bag and the provided tools. We'll pick up the back and the front of the machine, and we'll place the sides, always with the motor and pulley placed at the front of the machine. We'll need the 16 bolts from the bag, step 1, and we'll install them in all four corners, as you can see. There were a lot of bolts, guys, but they are finally all installed. And what we're going to do next is to install the two bolts that will hold the tensioners for the y-axis belts. They are located at the back of the machine, so that is 1 and 2. Next, we'll place the x-axis gantry on top, and we'll install it in place, inserting the four longer bolts from the top, and tightening them as you can see. Now we'll turn it upside down, since we're going to install the legs of the machine. So we are going to pick up the shorter legs, present them in place, and use the last set of bolts to install them in place. These solid legs will also act as rigidizers for our machine, which is pretty cool. Once we are ready with the feet of the machine, now that the laser is upside down, we'll install the synchronized rod that has too much plastic wrap on it, by the way, and it's going to go right here at the front of the machine. So as you can see, we'll insert it from the outside, passing it through the pulley, as well as through the coupling on the motor side. We'll then tighten all the bolts, and we'll be ready to go. Now we can turn the machine to its working position, and we're going to proceed with the last step of the build. Next, we're going to install the laser head itself, so we'll simply slide it through the mount, and we'll tighten the thumb screw at the back just like that. Pretty easy. With the extruder, guys, all the components of the machine are already in place. Now we'll only need to connect all the cables, and we'll be ready to test it. So to continue, I'm going to start sticking all the included cable mounts to run the cables from the electronic box all the way to the laser head. As you can see, we'll install three in the X-axis gantry just like that, and then we'll install some more at the bottom of the Y-axis of the machine, on the left-hand side. So that's the first one, second, and this will be the last one. Now, starting here next to the electronics box, we'll plug in the Y-axis motor as well as the Y-axis endstop, just like that. We can now pass the cable through the cable clips all the way through the Y-axis, and that was the third clip. Once we get to the X-axis, we'll plug in the X-axis motor and the X-axis endstop, and we'll continue passing the cable through the cable clips right here, till we get to the laser head itself, where we'll plug in the end of the cable with the help of a pair of pliers. As you can see, the machine moves very smoothly, both in the Y-axis as well as the X-axis. Now, here at the front, we're going to cut the zip tie holding the emergency button, and we are going to plug in the HDMI cable both in the electronic box as well as in the touch screen, that will magnetically attach to the electronics box just like that. Last step, we'll pick up the microSD card and we'll insert it in place. And last but not least, we'll insert the satisfying rubber tube for the air pump in place. For that, we'll use the last cable clip that was left and we'll stick it here. Finally, we'll insert the tube into the air compressor, as you can see. I'm actually going to use a zip tie to hold the two cables together, but be very careful and do not tighten it too much, just like that. Alright guys, looks that we have finished the assembly process of this incredible machine. As you have seen, all the components and materials look very premium, so I guess it won't disappoint us when we test it now. Okay, so once here in our testing bench, we'll place the honeycomb table that I borrowed from another laser, the ATEZR P10 laser machine itself, and the air pump that I'm going to quickly connect to the pipe going to the laser head. We'll also need the power adapter, and that little cable we unboxed at the beginning that will split our power output into two. So we'll connect the first output to the laser engraver, and the second one on the air pump. I'm going to test if it works, and it does, as you can hear. We'll finally turn on the laser, and as you can see, the touch screen will boot up. I have prepared a test file that contains laser engraving and cutting, and we're going to use it with the included Basswood sheets that are the size of more or less a credit card. So after framing the perimeter of the laser engraving, we'll start the work. This time in the SD card, we'll find a complete table with all the settings for engraving and cutting a lot of different materials, and from my experience, this one actually works. So as you can see, the engraving work is just perfect. We have set the speed to 3000 mm per minute and the max power to 300 or 30%. So the result has been fantastic, and now we're going to frame and run the laser cut program we have created for this test. This time we have set the speed to 700 mm per minute, power to 80%, and 5 passes. The result, as you can see, is incredible. Very clean cut that comes out just perfectly. Check out this result, guys. It is actually very good for the small size of this wooden card. Now we're going to make the same test with the transparent acrylic that was included in the box. We have set the engraving settings for translucent acrylic according to the table, but after a while looking, nothing seems to be happening here. So I've painted the acrylic black to test if it works now, and after framing the work, we'll go ahead and start it. As you can see, now it is definitely engraving something. We'll see the real result once we remove the paint, but before, I'm going to test the cutting in this transparent acrylic. After setting everything according to the table, I've made a lot of passes for the cut. And as you can appreciate here, the engraving seems to have worked perfectly, but the cutting has not definitely gone through, and at the back, the material is completely burnt. After having washed it, as you can see, the engraving is not very strong, and the cut did definitely not cut the material, but cracked it all around as you can appreciate at the bottom. Next test, this little black acrylic tag. One more time, I've made a design to engrave. As you can see, the result is just fantastic, so I'm going to start with the cutting work, and as you can see, it seems to be working as intended. Once the laser finishes, I'm going to pick up the acrylic tag, and as you can see, the cut got through perfectly. This is such a clean work, guys. As an ultimate test, I'm going to test if it can cut through this 2 cm spine wood I had laying around, and as you can see, it seems to be working as intended. Well, it did not cut through completely, but definitely we got to the bottom of the materials, 20 millimeters, guys. In a second attempt, I increased the number of passes, and as you can see, now we were able to cut through this quite thick pine wood. The cuts are so clean, as you can see. This machine definitely has incredible capabilities. At this point, we only have one more thing to test, and for that I'm going to remove the honeycomb bed, because I'm going to bring the ATEZR rotary tool. We're going to engrave a transparent glass water bottle that I have already painted black, as you can see. But we're not going to be able to raise the laser head enough to engrave this bottle. Just check it by yourself. So for this job, we're gonna need the 4 longer feet that I have right here, and I'm going to install real quick. Here we go. So now I'm going to turn on the laser and connect the rotary tool to the machine with the cable of the Y-axis motor. So we'll use this extender right here, and we'll bring it to the bottom left corner of the machine, where we'll plug it into the laser cable. Once done, we'll focus the laser, making sure the rotary tool and the X-axis gantry are parallel. And once we have our file ready, we're going to start the laser engraving work. So check this out, guys. As you can see, the engraving has finished, and we got quite good looking results, isn't it? Now I'm going to wash the black paint. And once with the paint off and full of water, check out this incredible result, guys. The ATEZR P10 laser engraved this glass bottle like butter. Having a closer look, check out the details, guys. Such a good job from this incredible machine. Alright, guys, so we're going to end the video here. To finish, please make sure you are subscribed to the channel, consider supporting my work on Patreon as all these amazing people does, and as always, see you in the next video.